Tim Fitzheim on this station. Steve, you're going to be a busy boy, aren't you?
I am indeed. I do like my listen again, though.
Good man. We like to hear that. Buy My Bloody Book is a performance book launch that you wanted to talk about.
Indeed. Chris Dobrowolski. Back in February, I went to see a show called All Roads Lead to Rome. I did review it on your programme. It was a sort of gently provocative travelogue and someone driving a Triumph Herald down to Rome and retracing his father's footsteps, who served with the Allies during World War II. I described it as a sort of Top Gear challenge without the nauseating testosterone, basically. It turns out Chris Dobrowolski is not primarily a theatre maker, but he is actually an artist, and these performance lectures, which is what he did then, are kind of part of what he does. But before that, he creates these wondrous machines, very much into sort of transport. He's created a T-chest aircraft that flies, a full-scale road-going pedal car, one-man hovercraft, and these all revolve around his theme of escape, which is the theme of this book that he has written, that he is launching at the Freudian Sheep Gallery next Tuesday, the 22nd, at 7 p.m. That's in St. Helen Street here in Ipswich. The book details his artistic life, but it's not heavy going for us. I've been lucky enough to get a copy. It's the funniest art book I've ever read in my life. As Chris himself said in an interview he did with us, which you can read on in Suffolk.com, there's no big words in it. It's very self-deprecating. It's full of humour. He attaches the titles loser and failure to himself quite regularly. But despite all this, and this sort of haphazard sort of garden shed technology that he's involved in this artistic way, he also found himself going to the Antarctic with the British Antarctic Survey as part of their writers and artists programme, with a sledge made out of gilt picture frames. There's pictures of that on his website. It really is an odd sort of go-kart travelogue, I think he described it as when I was speaking to him. It is a travelogue. It has pretensions towards a travelogue, but it's, as he said, more the sort of book two lads would write if they went to the end of the street in their go-kart. That's kind of, it's brilliant, absolutely brilliant. As I say, not a difficult read. He'll be launching that and doing a performance alongside it, including a organ is made out of car horns that plays the tune Tequila at the Freudian Sheep Gallery next Tuesday, 22nd. Tickets are a fiver, Foss.
Next Tuesday at the Freudian Sheep Gallery in St. Helen Street.
Yes.
I live round the corner from there. I don't know where that is.
Really? Well, you'll need to look for it on the way home then. I've not been yet, but I'm going next Tuesday. I'm looking forward to it.
I'm intrigued now.
Right, well, you'll have to take a look.
I must have walked past it several times.
You must have done. You'll notice it now.
Yeah, I will.
Now we've brought it up.
Okay, thank you for doing that. That's on Tuesday. We better play the track Tequila. There have been plenty of versions down the years. You know a good one by Los Lobos, which is online.
Yes, indeed.
Couldn't lay my hands on that particular rendition. I'm not sure they've ever released it on CD.
Don't know.
There's been plenty of other versions. Bad Manners did a version.
Yes, indeed.
A couple of great jazz guitarists, Wes Montgomery and Larry Carlton, they've done fine renditions. But we've got to play the original, haven't we?
I guess we have, really.
There's always a version by Dr. Feelgood I could throw in.
Why not?
I better not.
Have you reached your quota this month?
I think I have.
Okay.
We'll save that for another day. It was on their first album. It was mixed in with a version of Boney Moroney.
Okay.
In fact, the current lineup still do that same version, Boney Moroney, and then a bit of Tequila at the end of the show.
Oh, really?
But your eyes have glazed over now. I'm boring
no,
you.
No, not with Dr. Feelgood. You know me, I'm a bit of a fan. Not as big a fan as you, but I am a bit of a fan.
So we'll play The Champs, the original version of Tequila, and what a great one it is too.
Excellent.
And we'll speak to you again very soon, because you've been along to Jimmy's Farm to see Red Rose Chain Theatre Company.
I have.
Look forward to that.
Indeed.